Did you know that every single day the sun constantly beams 173,000 terawatts of free solar energy on Earth? Global energy consumption is around 18 terawatts, but less than 5% of that comes from solar power. That's insultingly low, isn't it? We need to pump those numbers up. So, let's understand the technologies we have to tap into all this incredible amount of solar energy. There are four types of concentrated solar power systems. The first one uses parabolic troughs. Basically, you get this curved, mirrored trough that reflects the sun's energy on a glass tube and carries synthetic oil or molten salt. The focused energy heats up the fluid to around 400 degrees Celsius. This type of system is usually fixed in place or moves in one axis of rotation. Overall, it has a maximum efficiency of 20%. The second type of concentrated solar power system uses a series of long, narrow, and mostly flat mirrors to focus light at a linear receiver positioned above the mirrors. This design uses a Fresnel reflector, and it's cheaper than the parabolic troughs since the receiver can be installed separately without direct support. The receivers are also placed on the sides in some variations. The next type of concentrated solar power system uses a parabolic dish and a Stirling engine as its power conversion unit. A parabolic dish is more effective in concentrating solar energy than the parabolic trough. It can heat the receiver up to 750 degrees or Celsius. The Stirling engine at the focal point converts heat energy to electrical energy. Parabolic dishes also track the movement of the sun in all directions, which boosts the efficiency of this system. The fourth type of design is called the power tower. In this setup, a tower stands like a celebrity, in the middle of a huge area called the heliostat field, surrounded by thousands of tracking mirror paparazzi. The receiver is placed at the top of the tower where molten salt gets heated to over 538 degrees Celsius. Then this molten salt moves down to heat storage tanks. Later on, it is used to drive a disappointing steam turbine to generate electricity. Out of these four concentrated solar power setups, the one that uses a Stirling engine is the real MVP, with an energy efficiency of 34%. All right, enough about concentrated solar power. Let's talk about photovoltaics now. Conventional solar cells are made from a single type of semiconductor material, usually silicon. Even the best of these can only reach a peak theoretical efficiency of 34%. The solar panels you can buy off the shelf typically have around 15 to 20% efficiency, but the latest generation of photovoltaics are taking it to the next level. They're using materials like gallium arsenide, which has the highest conversion efficiency, as well as other semiconductors stacked in layers. These are called multi-junction or multi-layer solar cells. Each layer in a multi-junction solar cell has a specific band gap and spectral absorption range to capture additional parts of solar spectrum. Visible light occupies a small portion in solar spectrum. Majority of the range is in the infrared zone. So, in multi-junction cells, gallium indium phosphide in the first layer works on the visible spectrum. Gallium indium arsenide in the second layer captures the near-infrared light, and germanium in the third layer captures far-infrared. This particular setup can reach a theoretical efficiency of over 45%. The downside is that these multi-layer cells are more complex and expensive to manufacture compared to the single-layer silicon cells. But that hasn't stopped the advancement of photovoltaics. Concentrated photovoltaics are in town now. This design uses Fresnel lenses to concentrate sunlight more than 100 times over a single solar cell. This seriously boosts the electrical output, but it also puts a lot of strain on the cells, potentially reducing their lifespan if the cooling isn't on point. That's why multi-junction cells are used in these concentrated photovoltaics, as they are more efficient and can handle a high density of light. Assuming maximum optical efficiency for the Fresnel lens, its aperture size divided by the size of solar cell, will give you the concentration ratio of such a setup. The takeaway: concentrated photovoltaics have the highest rank in terms of efficiency, followed by the best concentrated solar power setup, while conventional solar cells are at the bottom. Now, as for the cost, well, it depends on how much import taxes your country is slapping on Chinese solar panels, but the general trend has been a steady drop in prices over the last decade. The price drop of photovoltaics actually put a huge dent in the popularity of concentrated solar power. The best cost scenario for concentrated solar power achieves 7 cents per kilowatt hour compared to 1.3 cents for photovoltaics. However, concentrated solar power does have an advantage when it comes to long-term energy storage, since photovoltaics still rely on those pricey lithium batteries. That's all I got for you. Type your favorite solar design in comments. Also, don't forget to subscribe. Enjoy sunshine.